Hi, I'm Tony Foster, Senior Principal Engineering Technologist with Dell Technologies. In this video, we will demonstrate the steps necessary to upgrade a PowerFlex environment from PowerFlex 3.6.2 to PowerFlex 4.5. This is the second video in the PowerFlex 3.6 to 4.5 upgrade series and covers the task to update a workload cluster to PowerFlex 4.5. In the previous video, we covered the steps needed prior to updating the PowerFlex workload clusters. In the third video, we will cover upgrading storage-only clusters and HCI clusters. You can find the links to parts 1 and 3 in the video notes below. Before beginning a PowerFlex workload cluster update, there are some important things to cover. Please refer to the previous video for the procedure to update the PowerFlex management cluster to 4.5. This video is for illustrative purposes only. Many parts have been accelerated to fit the time allotted. It is assumed that a new PowerFlex 4.5 management platform, PFMP, has already been deployed in the environment, and the management environment has already been migrated to it. Deploying a new PFMP is beyond the scope of this video. This video assumes the necessary RCM packages have been downloaded from a Dell Digital Locker. The video also assumes familiarity with basic PowerFlex management operations. As with any maintenance operations, users are strongly encouraged to create a backup of their existing environment prior to attempting an upgrade. Advanced upgrade procedures are not covered in this video and should be directed to Dell technical support. Please contact your Dell technical support representatives for questions about the upgrade procedure. With that, let's get started. We'll start on the resources screen in PowerFlex Manager. Then we will select the PowerFlex system from the list of resources and click the Run Inventory button at the top left of the screen. Once the inventory is done, click Non-Compliant next to the PowerFlex system. Make sure the PowerFlex gateway is highlighted, and then click the Update Resources button. On the Update Resources screen, select all of the SDS nodes in the list. Then scroll down and click the Next button. Review the nodes to be updated. They may span multiple screens. Once satisfied, enter the confirmation text. Click the Finish button, then click Yes to confirm the upgrade. To view the job progress, click the Jobs icon in the top right corner of the screen. Wait for the update to complete. You can see that it is completed in the recent activity on the job. In the resources screen, we can also see that the update was successful, as it shows the PowerFlex gateway as compliant. Now we will re-inventory the environment by selecting all the resources and clicking Run Inventory. Several of the nodes will change to non-compliant. Click Non-Compliant for details. The compliance report loads and displays the non-compliant items. Click the Close button. The reason the nodes show as non-compliant is that the resource group is using an older compliance catalog. Let's update the catalog. From the Lifecycle menu, select Resource Groups. We will start with the Management Resource Group by clicking on the group's name. We will then click on the Non-Compliant link on the right of the screen. The Node Compliance Report is displayed. It shows the service catalog is 3.6.5.0. Click the Change button. This allows you to change the compliance file from the dropdown. Select the desired compliance file, enter the confirmation text, and click the Save button. After a few moments, the catalog changes. We will now apply the updated catalog to our resource group. To do so, click the non-compliant link in the top right of the screen. Select the nodes that are non-compliant, then click the Update Resource button. Select the appropriate maintenance mode and click the Apply button. Confirm and wait for the updates to complete. We can see the nodes as ESXi host being upgraded in the vCenter as well. We will now wait for the upgrades to finish. This can take a while and will vary depending on the number of nodes being updated. These same steps can be applied to other resource groups to bring them into compliance. Note that the update activity completed successfully. We see that some portions of the resource group show as non-compliant. If we look at a node compliance report, we see that one of the items is the vCenter. If we look at the nodes, we will see that they are now compliant. The other item that is not compliant is the Dell S4148 switch. If we look at the software components, we can see that they are compliant with the service catalog. This completes the upgrade of workload and management clusters. In the next video, we will demonstrate how to update the PowerFlex storage-only and HCI clusters.